Hello all, this is Sai Tosif and today we'll check a basic information about student teachers, what it is and what is the formula and how we can use a built-in functionality of Scilab for the student teachers. Okay, what it is and we'll check out these things. Okay, so student distribution is also, student teachers are also called as a student distribution. Okay, the theoretical work on T-distribution was done by W.F. Gossett. He published his finding under the pen name called Student. Why is Student is nothing but because he's working under the organization name as a student, and the condition of that organization, that one, they cannot publish their findings on their name. They have to publish with their organization. Okay, that is pen name Student. Okay. A t-test is mostly commonly applied when the test statistic would follow a normal distribution. If the value of a scaling term in the test statistics were known, there are two conditions and one more condition is there. Okay, so mostly commonly when we are going to use this one, when the statistics is a normal distribution, and another thing, the scaling term in the test statistics are known. And one more thing, why should not we go for normal distribution itself? Because if the samples is very less than 30, then normal distribution won't give proper result. So that is the reason we will go for student test. Okay, it is a normal distribution only with lesser values, lesser sample, and directly will come for formula. Okay, so in this one, the estimated value minus the value we hypothesis, okay, divided by standard error. Okay, remember, when we are going to use this student distribution is that one, when we have some hypothesis, means we have some criteria to check. Okay, then we'll check that criteria whether it is satisfying or not. Okay, when we are, okay, example, a company producing some LED bulb. Okay, example, or a company, Nokia mobile phone. Okay, they say that one, the battery life would be 2 years. The average battery life, what they manufacture, is, example, if they are manufacturing 1,000 batteries, right? They say that one, the battery life will be the 2 years. The mean battery life will be the 2 years. Might be it is lesser than or greater than, but here the condition, we have to test that battery life, right? So in that one, what we'll do, we'll take some sample and we'll use some sample, example 10 sample we'll take, we'll use the sample, and after using that samples, we get to know some battery will come up to 3 years, some battery will come 1.5 year, like this, right? So after recording all the examples, right, we'll came to know some result. Okay, after taking that result also, we cannot directly judge whether it is properly that what condition the company is telling that is satisfying or not. Okay, to verify that one, we go for some test, that is normal distribution test or something. If value is very less, sampling value is very less, then we'll go for t-test. Okay, I hope you guys have understood. This is the one way we are going to use the student t-test. And another one example, what is the use of t-test is to take the relation between two variables. Okay, whether how much they are relevant. Example, when you are making some tea, right? Simple example, the quantity of tea powder and the quantity of milk, these are two variables. Okay, what is the relation? If something is high and if you make low, right, what will happen? Okay, if we are completely eliminating one thing, what will happen? Like this, the relation between two variables is going to be checked in this t distribution. But first we will check that hypothesis. Okay, what is hypothesis? First, we are going to test with that one. Okay, so please remember this formula. So in this one, x bar is the mean of the sample. Okay, mean of the sample and mu is the mean of the population. We'll get to know what is mean of population, what is mean of sample and everything. S is a standard deviation and n is the number of taken sample, the sample size, you can say. The sample size is n. Okay, this is the formula. And yes, the S is defined as this one. The summation of x, x is a value, minus mean square divided by n minus 1. Here, n minus 1 is also we call as a degree of freedom. Remember, degree of freedom. Okay, so once again, I will repeat the formula. X bar is a mean of the sample. Okay, as an average of a sample, mu naught is a mean of the population, complete population, what company will say, right? Like 2 years is the company saying, right? That is 2 years is mu naught, okay? What actual we calculate the average, right? That is X naught. And S is a standard deviation. And here N defines the size of a sample which we have taken. And standard deviation is a square root of summation of X minus X bar. That is X value minus the mean square divided by the degree of freedom. That is N minus 1. Okay. Let's see one problem. Then we'll come to our programming. Okay. Okay. Before going for problem, let's check out what are the different functionality providing by the Scilab. How Scilab is providing the functionality. We know statistics is a complete one branch of a Scilab. Statistics is for the major role of statistics is to predict the future or to get some result properly, right? Example, here in statistics, cumulative distribution, under the cumulative distributive functions, CDFT is given, means cumulative distributive function of t-test, right? This is a t-test. In this one, CDFS will either can produce P and Q by taking T and DF. Here T is the distribution, T value, and DF is a degree of freedom, okay? Then if you provide these two values, if you specify PQ, then it will give you the probability of success and probability of failure. So P always defines the probability of success, Q defines the probability of failure. Okay, and another one thing, if you want T value, okay, you can pass the difference, okay, this degree of freedom, P value and Q value. As it is, we know that one, degree of freedom is nothing but the N minus 1. Okay, in this formula only we are getting N minus 1 is the degree of freedom. Example, sample is 10. Then 9 will be the degree of freedom, right? And P and Q is the probability. Okay, the confidence, the confidentiality limit, the significance ratio level that we specify with P and Q. And another one thing, the final value, degree of freedom, right? By passing P, Q, T, you can get it. So in this one, these three things, three types of different functionality we can use in the same function. Okay, what are the argument? P, Q, T, DF are real vectors of size. Okay, P, Q. Remember, if 75% is positive, means successful ratio is there, then remaining 25 is the failure ratio, right? The same way, if P is equal to 1, okay, some value is there, right? P is equal to 75%. Q will be 1 minus 75%, means 100 minus 75%, 25%. It will be always calculated like that only. So P depends on Q, Q depends on P. And T is the upper limit of integration of the T density, input range. DS, degree of freedom of the T distribution, okay? This is the way we are going to use. Okay, let's check out a problem now. Problem, okay, the manufacturer of LED bulb claimed that his bulb has mean life of 20 months. Means one LED bulb is going to be the mean average life of the bulb is 20 months. So a random sample has taken of 7 bulb. Okay, 7 bulb has been taken and we have tested that one. And the life of 7 bulb is come given as this. Okay, one bulb is came to 9 months, 21 months, 25 months, 16 months, 17 months, 14 and 21 months, right? This way it is came. Now we have to check. Verify the producer claim, whether the producer doing the claim that 20 months is proper or not using this 7 sample. Now we can easily say that one 20 is the population mean. What is mu? 20 is the population mean, the complete what the manufacturer is developed, that mean is 20. Okay, now what we are getting, right? In this sample, 7 sample mean is 19. So X bar is now 19. So X bar is 19. Mu is 20. From the question, we got these two things. So, and significance level, what they are saying, level 1 they are saying, means what is the failure significance, okay? And if you say that one, ulta, then 99% of confidentiality limit will come. Means 99%, what the question is, the claim has to come 99%. Okay, 99% the claim has to come. If it is not coming, we have to reject this hypothesis. Now, first the null hypothesis says that one, this is true. What the claim is there, okay? X bar is equal to mu. Okay, this is the hypothesis. Even though directly, approximately, we cannot say this one, they are not equal. But might be it is equal. The null hypothesis say. Okay. And P is 0.99. Yes, from the confidentiality, we know that one. P is 99. Q is 1 minus 99 is nothing but 0.01. Right? And degree of freedom is 6. How? N minus 1 is the degree of freedom. N is 7. We have taken the sample of 7. So N minus 1 becomes 6. Right? And standard deviation, if we calculate, it will become 3.86. Something approximate value it will come. So let's distribute these values in our program. Okay. Okay. Probability is P is 99%. Q is 0.1%. Okay, degree of freedom is 6. And now the same values we are passing to this one. And we'll get it. What value we'll get? Now the value is positive. Means the T value we are getting least value. What value we are getting? How much least value we will get? The difference value, right? That much we can say it is providing. Okay, now it is coming least value only. If it is coming more less value, right? Example, 0. Also, if it is coming, it is accurate value it was coming. Now it is coming 3 value also. Now this time also, the claim of the company is proving, successfully proving that one, okay? I hope you have understand what is the T value now. If T value, if you come, okay, difference is somewhat, if you provide like, let's provide 40, let's check out, like difference is 1 only, like 31. Okay, difference if you are giving only 1 sample, 0, only 2 sample we have taken, and with that one we got this result, then we can say it is not a properly, means it is not approximately claiming, means the claim is not fulfilling, we can say, okay. Now the freedom is 6. And we are getting the key value is very less only. So in this case, we can say this one, the claim of the company is fine. So this is one way we can do. And another one example is the key value you can pass, difference value we can pass, and we can get it P and Q. P is the probability of success. Q is the probability of failure. Remember, always the probability will be 1, okay? If P is equal to, okay? The probability always will be will be always 1, okay? And if you are giving P is equal to 90, okay, 0.9, 90 is nothing but 0.9, then Q will be, okay, will be 1 minus P. Always is going to be happen like this, that is nothing but the 0.1, right? This way it is going to be calculate the P and so the both, if we combine the both P and Q value, it will be always 1, okay? So here you can check out the same result I am passing here, T value I am passing, and I am passing the degree of freedom as a 6, and then I am passing this degree of freedom and T value to the cumulative function, okay, of T, and I'm getting the P and Q values. Okay, you can check out the same value we got it, right? The Q is 0.1% only, P is 99%, we got it, right? This is all about how we can use a t-test in Scilab, okay? I hope you have understood how we can use this all, okay? Thank you all. Thank you for watching this video.